Coffee tonight. Good evening, friends, and thanks for tuning in. All right, calm down now. I know you're feeling the same way as me. It's going to be all right. It's going to be a great show. We know that. But tonight is our last show for the summer, our last show. Oh! And it should be a sad occasion, but it's not, is it, Will?
It's not, Chris.
Will, are we sad?
What?
Are we sad?
We're not sad,
no,
we're happy.
No, we're not. Can you not hear me, Will?
I can't. Say it again.
Are we sad here? Charlene, who flew in from New York to do that for us today. She flew in from New York today, so thank you very much for doing that for us. But now, you can't buy that song in your shop, by the way, it's just for us, so thank you, double thank you, Charlene. But now we've had 146 guests on TFI Friday since we started, which isn't bad. Now here's guest number 147, also known as Paul McCartney. Some questions, shall we? I think that's what we should do now. Paul, thanks for coming on the show. Can't believe you're here. Thank you very much indeed. Okay?
Okay, Chris.
Now, I've been preparing for this interview for like 2 weeks.
Looks like it, yeah.
And if you look at... Look, this is all around my house. Every time I thought of a question, I just wrote it down, and here are all the questions that I'm going to ask you in the next few moments. But this week, right?
Yeah.
I've been thinking about my opening question. This week, I've been thinking about one thing to ask you straight away.
Yeah.
If you don't mind. What about all this rain?
What is it? Well, like it's my fault or something?
No, no. Well, no, you are quite high up there. Maybe you could have a word. Yeah. Well, you've got a farm, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got. We like this rain on the farm.
Is it good for you?
Very good.
No troubles, no rivers?
No, not yet.
No, okay. All right.
Streams
then.
Are barely bulging.
Okay. Do you have any Oxbow Lakes at the moment?
No Oxbow Lakes.
Okay. Do you manage your own farm? Are you in charge of it? Are you heavily involved?
Sort of, yeah, but a lot of people do the stuff, really. I okay. just say, that's good.
Yeah?
That's good. Very good.
But you ride your horses through the land and you go...
I ride my horses, yes, both of them.
And you go chopping your trees and thinking about
things?
Do a
bit of that, yeah. Do a bit of that.
And that's where you work, isn't it? You do your work there.
What kind of work?
Well, you know, you do your recording and
singing
stuff.
Singing and that, yeah, about 20 minutes away from where I live.
Singing in that, by the way.
Yeah.
And is that where most of your new album was done, Flaming Pie? Was it all done there?
Yeah, it was all, except one track.
Okay, where was that done?
That one track was done at Steve Miller's ranch in Sun Valley, Idaho.
Okay. Well, it's nice when you've got friends like Steve Miller, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Cheap studio, you know, just says, come on over. Love it.
Now, Flaming Pie is the name of the album, so we've got a little present for you.
Yes.
So you like us straight away, all right?
Yes.
We've got you, Paul. This is great. We have got you a Flaming Pie. And that will flame for as long as you flaming well like each other.
Yes, it's going to really get hot in here. I've got a Flaming Pie lighter for you.
Oh, hey,
and actually, it works.
Okay, great, brilliant.
And that will go out, unlike this one.
Okay, well, this will stay here forever, as if it's not hot enough in here.
Yeah,
already.
It's really boiling.
Is that a good replication of the Flaming Pie on the album?
It's an exocant. That's an exocant replica.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, it's not bad. Did you draw that?
I drew that, yeah.
Okay, right, okay. You draw a lot of things, don't you?
I do, Chris, yes. It's a bit like the yes-no interlude, isn't it?
Yeah, I bought something at an auction once that it was claimed that you'd drawn, and I want you now to tell me whether or not you did draw this. It's okay, a self-portrait. Okay. Have we got that? Did you draw that?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I did, yeah. But did you buy it?
I did buy it, yeah.
I think you got a little bargain there, Chris.
It's not bad, then, is it?
Not bad, no, that's pretty good.
Do you know, that's £600 worth.
Is he really?
So what I've
back.
But what I've got here is I've got a pad, and if you want to doodle at all, yeah, it's a bit of screwing yourself. You can, I'm saying.
You know what that's like when.
I mean, I've got a spare penny case. I've got another pen here. I've got some more paper.
I'm not going to do it. You know what this is like when.
She loves you, yeah.
No. George Harrison once bit into a piece of toast.
Yeah.
In America, when we did the big Beatles thing, and it went at Sotheby's for 14,000.
I'll tell you your point.
I wouldn't do
all
that.
Right, okay.
Just give me some toast.
No problem.
Only thing is, the next day at breakfast, my kids are saying, "You don't want that toast, do you, Dad?" Leave it. We'll have that.
Well, look, I have been McCartney'd up all week, right? And this is your little album cover from your album, right? This is it.
Maybe
is it
right book.
Here? Okay, this is it. And this is what you get with the album, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I'm listening to the songs literally all week.
Yeah.
And it's fantastic. I'm not just saying that, but it's a great.
Thank you. Yes, thank you.
And so what I've done is I've written some questions alongside the songs. That's what I did. So all my questions. I've got questions here. I've got questions everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you a couple of these now. First of all, is it true that you tell a fib in this booklet about one of the songs?
You better remind me a bit.
Okay.
About what are we doing here?
Well, it's a song called Some Days, right? And you said of Some Days, I'd driven Linda to a photo session for one of her cookery assignments.
Right.
Fair enough. Nice,
true.
Nice that, bloke.
So far, which
okay. One? Knowing she'd be out about 2 hours, I set myself a deadline to write a song in that time so that when she'd finished and she said to me, "Hey, what did you do?" I said, "Well, I wrote a song because that's what I do."
Right.
Is that true?
That is true.
It's not.
What do you know that I don't?
I heard that it was Jeff.
Yes.
Who nipped out your publicist?
Yes.
And you've substituted Jeff's name for Linda's.
No.
Well, that's what he said.
Completely true. No, we do. He's a liar.
Oh. Well, I'm going to agree with you, not him. And you know, there's the songs we were singing, right? Track one.
Yeah.
Right. You always say we always go back to the songs we were singing.
Yeah.
Right. So what were those songs that you went back to? Because this is a retrogression of you in the '60s with the lads, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, you know, I mean, like the Tonight, Satisfaction.
Yeah.
Was one.
Right.
I don't know, you know, lots of songs we go back to, don't we, Chris?
Yeah, I know, but
surely you come back with me in time.
I would love to.
Through songs.
I would absolutely
love
to.
We could do it right now.
All right. But you did it at midnight, you'd always go back to same things.
Yeah, you know, a lot of songs, yeah.
You also
depends
said
how far you want to go back.
But you also said that you're remembering the 60s, sitting around late at night, dossing, smoking pipes and drinking wine.
That wasn't me, though. That was the publicist again.
Oh, all right. I dread all the other questions, then. OK, you say in The World Tonight, you said, I go back so far, I'm in front of me.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It's a very philosophical line, actually.
I know.
You're related to Einstein's theory of relativity.
Right.
If you go back far enough, you will, in fact, be in front, Chris.
Is that
of
true?
Yourself.
Because now I feel like an idiot.
No.
Is it also true that you said that John would love that line?
Yeah, I think he would, actually, yeah.
Why?
Serious for a moment. It is one of those lines that when you write it, I write stuff and I just let lines come to me. And that one came, I go back so far, I'm in front of me, and I thought, what does that mean? But I imagine, you know, I was just checking it with John. I said, oh, that's rubbish. And he said, no, that's a good line.
Did you check it with him?
I think I checked it.
Okay, all right. Now, on that subject, right, I've now realised that I don't need any of these questions.
I wouldn't bother with this.
On that very subject, I got told also this week that you do actually believe in magic, real magic.
Yeah, I suppose.
Not tricks,
you know,
just
not
magic.
Not tricks, yeah. I think there is a certain magic in the air, you know, if you're lucky, that will come to you. I mean, you know, probably my best known song was Yesterday, and I dreamed.
Well, you had a few, Paul.
Well, well, I'm going to the best known, Chris.
All right, okay, all right.
Stay with me.
I'm with you all the way, man. I'm with you all the way. Can't believe I'm here.
You
what a
can't
dream.
Well, what were we talking about?
Yeah, we were talking about
Yesterday.
Yeah.
That's okay. I dreamed that song, Chris.
Nice.
So, you know,
yeah, yeah.
That makes me believe that. You know, normally you'd think I sat down and go, yes, and wrote it.
Right.
But it just came unto me in a dream. So I think that's sort of a form of magic, you know.
Now, if I said to you about this album, about the fact... Oh, I'm with you all the way. I just want to get as many questions in as possible, right? If I said that the album itself, you've gone back, you have actually gone back yourself, haven't you?
Yeah.
It's not like any other McCartney album. Is that right?
Mm.
Would that be right?
Yeah.
And was that because you were watching all the anthology stuff?
Yeah, I think that's what it was, yeah. Doing a lot of listening back to all the old tracks for the Beatles anthology. And just you know, hearing how simple and direct and easy it all was, and hearing the humour on the sessions. You know, you don't hear people going, OK, guys, it's all like, shut up, soft ass. And, you know, and then they go, oh, and we go into the take, you know, there's a very good atmosphere in the studio. So I thought, well, you know, it'd be silly to do anything other than that. So I kept this album very simple, direct, and not so serious.
Right. Well, you said, you also said, as far as this album is concerned.
Yeah.
I heard you say this on videotape, right? You said, let us have a laugh, let us not sweat, let us put an album out, end of story. Right? That's a lot simpler than it's been over the last few years, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, normally for everyone, you get rung up by the record company and they say, we want you to go to, it's normally Cologne.
Right.
They want you to go for some reason. They want you to go to Cologne. And you say, yes, I'll go to Cologne. And you meet millions of people. Oh, yes, it's good, Alvin. Yeah, it's good, yeah. Go to Cologne. And you wonder what you're doing there often, you know. And so on this album, I thought, well, I'll let the album go to Cologne.
Right.
I'll stop here.
Okay. But you also said about it, and this was in the Q interview, which is stuck to this part of the desk. You said that you didn't give it was a hit. Now, I can't believe that.
You know, the thing is, releasing this album and had such a success, or the Beatles had such a success with the anthology, that I seriously did think, you know, that sold 20 million. What am I going to do now? Worry about the next hit?
Right.
I mean, at some point, you've got to think 20 million is 20 million, and I don't give a...
But you seem happier.
Yeah, well, it was a very good attitude, you know, because I say you're normally worried about it and stuff. I think if you don't worry, that's maybe that magic we're talking about. It gives a little room for things to happen, you know, rather than just...
Now, you're a sir.
Yes.
How are you coping with that? Do you think it sounds daft?
No, it's... my dad would have said, is that spelt C-U-R? But, it's very unusual, you know, for a common man like me, Chris.
But have you got acquired poshness?
Huh?
Have you got acquired poshness nowadays?
I don't know. You know, I've always... People say to me, oh, you're not working class because you've earned a lot of money. I say, I am, you know. Yeah. I will not relinquish that working class thing just because I've got a lot of money.
They like that.
That
they
for
like
working
that.
Class?
They like
all right, for the working classes! But, so, you know, it's such a huge honour,
right.
It's such a high honour that, you know, I love it. But, you know, it surprises me when people call me that.
Because the posh people that always surrounded you, I mean, the four lads, you were the band, right?
Yeah.
But you were surrounded by posh people. I mean, Brian Epstein was dead posh, wasn't he?
Brian was, yeah, when you think back on it. Yeah.
And George Martin is the poshest man in the world.
George is very
good. He is Squadron Leader Martin.
You mean Sir George.
Yeah, Sir George.
Yeah, yeah.
And what's his name? Derek Taylor. Right?
Derek's pretty posh.
Derek's
yeah.
dead
yeah,
posh.
He is, yeah.
They were all dead posh.
Yes.
So well, do we need posh people, do you think?
Yeah, I think, you know, when we were starting out, we didn't know, you know, how to get gigs and stuff, you know, like you don't. And you need the posh people because they know where places are. They've got a car.
Exactly.
They've got a car.
All right, well, look, we've got to take a break, but you're going to stick around, aren't you, for a bit?
Yeah.
And he's going to play a couple of songs for us as well.
Yeah.
Very glad to have Paul McCartney with us tonight. Now, Paul, on your new album, you play most of the instruments yourself.
Play a lot of them, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
And you're a great drummer, apparently.
Well, I do a bit, you know, on the sly.
Can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this?
No, that's not called for in many of the songs which I do.
Can you do it?
Can I do it? No.
Go on, have a go. Yeah! He knew he could do it.
Near it.
Now look, we've had some friends faxes with some questions, and these are the genuine faxes. We're going to show them on the screen just to prove it to you. If you want the proof, there you are. And the first question is from Bono. Bono's faxed us from America. We've asked all these people if they could ask Paul one question, what would it be? And here's the fax from Bono. It says, Paul, when I hear someone else's great song, I feel both elated and sick as a pig that I didn't write it. Do you ever feel the same way? From Bono.
Yeah, sometimes. Not really sick as a pig. I'm slightly jealous.
And is there any one song that you thought, oh, that I'd like?
Yeah, you know that Billy Joel one, Don't Go Changing, do-de-do-de. I thought that was very good myself.
All right, that's Bono's. Sean Ryder faxed us with a question. Sean Ryder. Sean's question is, what were you on when you wrote the Frog Chorus? Now, that's Sean's question, not mine, OK?
Yeah. I was smoking pipes and drinking wine late at night, but, you know, it's inspirational, I thought.
OK, all right. Well, that's Sean's question.
What were you on?
Question for Sir Paul McCartney from Richard and Judy, this one. Here it is, genuine facts. Why are you on TFI Friday and not this morning?
It's a much cooler show.
But we like them, don't we?
But we love them, we do love them, yeah.
Now, I think this is an absolute cracker from Robert Smith of The Cure. Dear Paul, have you ever made a crop circle? I've heard rumours that you're involved. Can you pass on any tips? As when I tried to do one in Wales recently, it went horribly wrong with Robert.
Yeah, well, Robert, love. What you have to do, you lie in a field and your feet must be at the centre of a circle and you shuffle around a few times and then big jumps out.
Huge
That's
jumps.
How I do it, very big jumps.
Skippy-like jumps.
Very skippy, hippity-hoppity, out of the field and ring the daily thing.
All right, get the photograph. Yeah. Have you ever had any crop circles in your part of the world?
No, we don't get a lot down where I am.
Are you Sussex or Kent?
Sussex.
All right. You sure?
Yeah, I'm dead sure.
Oh. I thought you were in Kent.
I think so.
George Best has faxed us. George says, I was once known as the fifth Beatle. Where's my royalties percentage? Can you fax? There he is.
Yeah, it's in the post, George. some delays due to Christmas.
OK. We've got another one here. And this is... Oh, you'll like this one. This is from Ringo Starr.
Oh, yeah. No, really?
Yeah.
Really?
It really is, from Starling Music Limited.
Rockin'.
Yeah. All right. Ringo's question to Paul is, who is his favourite Beatle?
That's not an easy one, Rings. There's no answer, and he knows there's no answer to that. I love you all.
Because Ringo's playing drums on the album, isn't he?
He is, and he's gorgeous.
On Beautiful Night.
I do love him very, very much, but no favourites amongst my children.
OK. George is a bit weird, isn't he?
Nah. No, he's very good, our George. He's lovely. He's lovely.
He's out there, though, isn't he?
He's no, not really.
He is.
No. He isn't. He's done a great album with Ravi Shankar called Chance. Yeah, it's very out there, but lovely.
It?
Yeah, gorgeous.
All good?
Yeah, penultimate track, Cracker.
All right. Melinda Messenger.
Yeah.
Right. To Alex, she says, which is strange, but she doesn't. Has requested a question for Paul McCartney. If you could be in one of the bands that are around now, which band would it be?
Whoa, well, it would have been Nirvana, but no longer.
Right.
And now, who would it be? Joe Loss.
I didn't
know. You've got to go for the name Joe Loss.
All right, OK.
Joe Loss, yeah.
All right,
man.
Couple more. Ian Brody. Ian Brody of the Lightning Seeds, everyone. Sir Paul, he says here.
Yes. Yeah.
Which footy team, red or blue? He doesn't know, apparently.
Blue. Blue.
Long story, because I claim both of them, which isn't really allowed, I know, but my dad was born in Everton.
Right.
So I'm officially Everton, but they don't do very well. Liverpool do, and I love Liverpool too, so I'm having both.
You're having both,
and
right.
I don't care. Right, Liverpool.
Now, this is another crack at Frank Carson, right? Yeah. In Frank's handwriting, 26th of June, 97. Dear Paul, what was the ticket to ride for a bus, train or plane? And, ticket to ride. And why would you be sad if the girl that's driving you mad was going away? If she was driving you mad, you'd be happy.
It's very good, actually, that.
Great question.
That's a very good
question.
Yeah, that is, yeah. It was a bus,
right?
Actually, that we were on.
Yep.
And the girl that was driving us mad at the time, we were getting away from her. We're very happy to get away from her. And I don't actually have an answer to that, frankly.
But it's a good question.
It's a heck of a question, yes.
Okay.
He knocked on my door once we were doing some show. He says, "I just called to say I love you." yeah, but I can't answer.
All
that,
right,
Frank.
Final That's one. Too this difficult. Is the final one. To Paul from Delia Smith, right? Yeah. To Paul, although you are a strict veggie, do you still get the urge to eat meat? A nice juicy bit of pork with crackling, perhaps?
No, Delia, I see this nice juicy piece of pork as a little piggy with a life. And I don't want to kill it.
Never.
I love it. I stroke it.
Because you know bacon is the downfall of many vegetarians, isn't it? The smell of bacon.
And that, yeah, but you can do coffee in the morning if you want.
You can
that
do that
one.
If you want.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
And they're making fake bacon anyway now. They're making it all
I had
fake.
I had some fake.
You did? You had
a fake meat
bologna
sandwich
yesterday.
Right,
yeah.
Now, we've got to get on with some music, but just before you go, I've got another present for you, because I don't know if you've got this, but you know I collect Beatles stuff. And I got you some Beatles wallpaper unused. There you go.
Oh, I wouldn't like that. Is very
like that?
Nice. Yeah, I would have that. Well, I'll have that.
That's for coming on the show.
That's wonderful,
okay.
Thank you.
Now, would you sing as a couple?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Are we standing up?
We're going to go.
Standing up.
Paul McCartney is now going to sing for us. this? Can you believe this? He's going to do another song for us in a second. I've just got to tell you that he's actually playing with himself there. He's recorded all the extra bits. He's recorded all the extra bits, and on the monitors, he's actually playing the songs. Paul's going to do another song in a moment for us. But can I just say, thanks very much for watching the last year and a half of TFI Friday, and have a great summer. Will you have a great summer, please? Will you have a great summer from us? OK. Now we'll go back to Paul. I think Paul's ready on the stage with his guitar. Paul, back to you, man.
Okay. Thank you. Here's one I prepared earlier. It's called Young Boy.
Thank you very much to Paul McCartney. Thanks to you, of course, because you're the most important people. Thanks for watching the show. Have a great summer. We'll see you in September. Come on, let's go and enjoy the summer.
All right, let's go.
Here you go. It's on the red carpet. Ah.
Keep going. And don't fall in, whatever you do. And we are running. Okay. Rock it. We got it. Let's hit it. All right, fast as you like.
Go, Bruman.
Exclusive to 4.